Serafina and the Black Cloak, and me and my mom are going to answer questions about the book because we both read it. So the first question is, what does this statement mean? The statement is, our character isn't defined by the battle we win or lose, but by the battle we get to fight.
Well, about choice, don't you think? Like, do you choose to fight? Because you could pick something easy and win, but just because you win, does that mean that you're a better person or you've learned something?
About Serafina,
yeah,
and how she looks different.
Mm-hmm.
She's kind of hidden down in the basement.
Yeah, it means like you should go out there and just be yourself and express yourself like you are,
mm-hmm.
like everybody else, but you're really
right. Because Serafina is a nice girl, a smart girl, could do lots of things.
So, yeah, he shouldn't have tried to hide her in the basement.
Well, let her be herself.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Okay. The next one is, the black cloak allows a person to gather incredible knowledge and skills. Would you wear this black cloak?
I would not wear the black cloak.
I wouldn't either.
And then there's three parts to this question. So is the second part is wearing and using the black cloak right or wrong?
I think it's wrong because you don't want to know everything. You want to have to learn stuff throughout your life and, like, think about, like, have to think about stuff and,
Well, I think the black cloak, when they talked about when she put it on, it was overwhelming.
Yeah.
Because she had all of this good and bad that she was having to deal with, and it was immediate, and it was all right there, and she could see it in her, like, peripheral vision or whatever, and that was too much.
It was too much, it was overwhelming, and you couldn't think about anything because you knew everything.
Mm-hmm. But I wouldn't necessarily say it was wrong. It depends on how you use it. Like, I don't think it was immoral
for her to use it.
Mm-hmm. So then the third part is, or does it depend on how you use it? It's like, as you said, it's like, it depends on how you use it. Because, like, if you're using it for, like, to know, like, why someone is sad so you can help them, that's fine. But if you're using it to know all the answers to the math test, then that's wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The next question is, what are Serafina's characteristics, and how do you describe her personality / character to someone?
Her characteristics are, like, she has, like, brownish eyes, like...
Well, I think this is more her character rather than what she looks like physically. I think that she's very smart.
She is very smart. She's
clever, too, which is a little different.
Yes.
You know, she's able to problem solve and figure out how to get out of situations or how to help people.
She's able to think, like, if I do this, then this is going to happen to me later.
Mm-hmm.
But if I don't do this, then this is going to happen to me. So which one is better? And she chooses between those two.
I think she's also a very good friend.
Yes.
She didn't have friends because she had been hidden off for so long.
Well, and she finally found Brayden.
Right. She was a very good friend to him and really treasured that relationship, mm-hmm. Which I think sometimes we take our own friends for granted. But she really wanted to be around him and wanted to know more about him and wanted to do things for him and be kind and everything. She was very kind.
She was
respectful.
Very kind and caring.
I thought she was very respectful, mm-hmm. you know, with her dad.
Yeah.
You know, she had stayed hidden for so long and her, and she respected that, you know, that
and
was the rule
felt,
that her dad had
she
said.
She felt bad that she left whenever she first mm-hmm. left. The basement where she was supposed to stay and be hidden.
Right.
Okay. Next question is, this book can be described as historical fiction, but it also has elements of fantasy. List some elements that would fall into each category. So, first let's do historical fiction. So,
it's set in 1899.
The setting, Biltmore Estate.
Well, when Biltmore was a home that people lived in, as opposed to now, it's a museum.
Yeah.
So, you know, they talked about the Vanderbilt family and, mm-hmm. you know, what they did and what they were like and their relationships and what was going on at the time. You know, news that was happening at the time or things that were happening, events that were happening at that time. That would be the historical part. The fiction part is obviously Serafina.
Yeah, Serafina.
And her family. And
the magical mm-hmm. stuff and like how...
So that would be the fantasy part.
Yeah, and fantasy, it's also like no person can be half human, half mountain lion.
Yeah,
some
sort of cat thing.
That's weird. That's just weird.
Yeah. It's interesting.
Yeah.
And there's no magic cloak
out
there that takes people's souls.
That's weird. That's just weird.
Well, that's the fantasy part.
It's just weird.
So.
Okay, so the next one is, in 1899, when the story takes place, most homes are very primitive. What are some of the technological advancements in Biltmore Estate? One is the little machine that they have that generates mm-hmm. electricity that they have. Mm-hmm. And then, don't they have indoor plumbing?
They do have indoor plumbing. They had indoor lighting.
Yes.
Which was an issue when that machine, when that machine died, then they didn't have electric lights.
Was it like a pulley or something?
No, it had a name, but I can't remember what it was. That's okay. I don't think you have to
look
it up right
now. So those are the technological advances. And the last question is, at the beginning of the story, how is Serafina's life different from Biltmore's other inhabitants, like the Vanderbilts, the guests, and the Sturmans?
She doesn't
have friends.
Well, she didn't have her own house.
That's true.
She lives in the basement.
She lives in the basement, hidden from everybody.
Mm-hmm. They don't have a lot of food. They cook over a little stove.
Yeah,
she doesn't like grits.
She hides. She sleeps on a mattress behind the stove mm-hmm. thing.
They have to hide during the day.
Yeah.
Whereas Biltmore is a huge house, and so the Vanderbilts had a lot of room.
Yeah, but they can't go up there because Pa said.
Mm-hmm. Well, they don't even know she exists. Well,
yeah.
So it was very different. The guests are.
Guests
also
are,
wealthy.
They all have nice clothes and they don't, well, they do get money, but then they can take a shower.
They have nice cars
have nice
and
cars.
Horses.
Well, they have cars?
Yeah, they have cars.
They have cars?
Yeah, but only the very wealthy.
Oh, that's awesome.
That's why the Vanderbilts had it.
They had big, nice rooms with linen cloth. Big blankets that they could be worn.
Mm-hmm. Yep. They have a lot more stuff.